Hello and welcome back to another episode on a Mechanist server. So, finally, it's time again. A lot happens and I unfortunately wasn't able to take part in a lot of it. But yeah, I'll show you everything that happened. The first thing is actually a new ice farm. So, we already made a 72,000 per hour ice farm a while ago, but Andrew kept working on it and he made a far better version. So we also built that one actually quite a while ago, I think. It's been over a month since we built that. But yeah, unfortunately I hadn't had time to show it to you yet. So here's the bedrock field, it's still at the first layer, but we already removed all the netherrack in between. And there's the portal for the new ice farm. And here we are, the perimeter decoration is not finished yet. I'm not even sure about the plans, to be honest. But yeah, this is the new ice farm. Looks so much better in my opinion. It's also way more lag efficient. It's even more reliable and it's just everything about it is better than compared to the old one. So at the top here, we have modules where, wait, let me go into spectator mode. So here we have the ice generation. This water here doesn't turn into ice because it's only waterlogged slabs. And here are sticky blocks that pull the ice down. And when the ice is pulled down, it gets pushed forwards and backwards once. So it turns into block 36. And while it's in block 36, these sticky blocks can go up again without pushing the ice up again. So this way, it's possible to always have ice coming down here once it's finished, and we don't need any piston worms or anything like in the older design. But then we have very clear structure of modules here, which I really, really like. They all get pushed into the middle. A lot of piston tapes. Then here's kind of a buffer as far as I know. And then this gets converted into a vertical stream. This gets sent in the middle to the player here, and then the player mines it here. So this farm is 72,000 ice per hour again. It's more reliable though, and it even has different modes. You can, because it's like structured in modules like that, you can only run 1/7 of the modules, so only one. You can run 2, 3, 4 and so on. And then we also have a true 72,000 ice per hour mode, which is the most reliable one, and there's like only a really, really small chance that you miss a single ice per hour. But in Andrew's testing, he didn't even miss one, so that's really, really reliable. So let's hop out of spectator again, fly there in survival. I can show you a little bit better. Here we have the storage for all the ice again. I think it starts filling here. Yeah, here we already have a few shulker boxes. Then down here in these barrels, there are the empty shulker boxes. This is for the insurance spot again, in case the player gets kicked or anything. And then we have the zombie pigman XP farm again. Let me get a snowball real quick. We also have a snowman here for unlimited snowball supply now. And I'm creating layers, that doesn't help me. Nice. Wait, let me check if I have another shovel. That might be a fortune shovel. Yeah, okay, that's good. That's not a silk touch. You can just send here, mine a few snowballs. And then take those. And here there are supposed to be pickaxes, but there are none. Then you can just go here, throw a snowball at the pigman. Oh, that's loud. And if you put in the insurance spot, you can just push this button and the ice farm starts and you can start mining ice here. There will also be a video, a more detailed video about this ice farm soon. Kinda overdoing it, to be honest. I'm doing like a really, really intense cinematic for some reason, and that takes quite a while. So yeah, that video will be released in maybe a few days or even weeks. So the next project is a new raid farm. We built a raid farm by CCS Covenant, the new fastest stacking raid farm. And yeah, it's ended up looking really well in my opinion. It's insanely fast, lag efficient. It's just a really insane raid farm. I love it. Oh yeah, one thing I forgot to mention. The ice farm perimeter was actually sped run, and we managed to do it in a little bit over 9 hours, if I remember correctly. So that also was a lot of fun. Me and a few other people even streamed it on Twitch. So here we are at the new raid farm. I actually had to ask Slipsy where it is. This should be the what's the effect called? Yeah, I also love the decoration here. I think Elo made the decoration. It looks like really good, like a 90s diner, something like that. Oh yeah, the Bad Omen Bank. Yeah, that's the effect called. So this is the Bad Omen Bank. So here you can get Bad Omen whenever you want to start the raid farm. Yeah, there are all the pillagers. I'm not entirely sure how this works, to be honest, so I won't try it now. But the basic idea, as far as I know, is to use the pillagers that we have stored here to get the Bad Omen effect, and with that you can start the raid farm. So, next, let's go to the raid farm. That's this portal here. And here we are. Also, really love the decoration of this. That's in my opinion the best type of decoration, when you can still see the genius of the farm itself, the way it's designed and everything, but it still looks good. So they only used a few green accents and black, and yeah, I really like the way this looks. So as I said, this is CCS Covenant's raid farm. Produce an insane amount of redstone dust, emeralds and everything. And yeah, this is basically our new redstone farm, because the witch farm is actually way slower than this. And if you go up here, you need to stand here to activate it, and yeah, I'm not entirely sure where you need to stand, to be honest, but yeah, you basically stand here somewhere and always hit the mobs. These here are wax suppressors, so those don't attack you, those are these small annoying things that nobody wants. We have two of those. And yeah, up here the mobs would spawn. The ravagers get teleported to the nether and killed there with plain lava. And then all the mobs drop. Here are some suppressed snow layers. CCS also made a small video showing how you can make those. It's actually really easy. And yeah, then they get funneled here somewhere, and then you can kill them easily. And yeah, the items obviously get transported off into the storage. So if you want to see this farm in action, I suggest you check out CCS's video. I'll also link that in the description. Okay, what was that? So here, that's Ken, by the way. That's the Bad Omen Bank that we have been at earlier, and yeah, I really love the way this looks. It's just a giant mech can. I think Elo also made the outside decoration of this, and yeah, I just love it. It looks like a Coke can, but it says mech. The perimeter itself, unfortunately, isn't decorated that much. It's just clean walls and a flooded floor. And the last project I want to show you today is my huge fungus farm that we actually built on the server. Because for the decoration of the gold farm perimeter, the void perimeter that I showed you last episode, we actually needed some ward blocks in the overworld side. And because it would take way too long with actual nether wards, we decided to build a nether fungus farm, and yeah, build that up in our white perimeter where our batbot used to be. So I don't want to show that in survival, because if you're in survival, there's a good chance that one of the Nihilium or multiple of the Nihilium will turn into Netherrack, which decreases the efficiency of the farm drastically. We'll just use our survival spectator here and teleport to the fungus spot here. So here it is in the white perimeter. It's currently running in warp mode. And yeah, we already made quite a lot of warped stems and so on. We compost warp blocks. But yeah, earlier we ran it in crimson mode, and we also wanted to get the warp blocks. So instead of having a bone meal output here, we had a bone meal input, because without the warp blocks, it couldn't compost enough to be self-sustainable. And yeah, instead of composting the warp blocks, we filtered them out and also pumped them into the storage here. But yeah, then we had enough warp blocks. Unfortunately, the farm even crashed for some reason. I'm still not entirely sure why this happened, but Philo repaired it and now it's running in warp mode, fully self-sustainable. And yeah, we are currently getting stems and shroom lights. So that's already it for today. Unfortunately, it was only showing a few farms that we made, but the next episode will be more interactive again and I'll show you again how we do stuff. So I'll see you until then, and I hope you enjoyed. Bye bye!